Hello, my name is King Tu, and I am a student of Mrs. Felipe's computer programming class. Today, I'll be presenting to you my game known as Fairy Hunter that I've created in her class. Thanks to Mrs. Felipe's teaching us how to code, I was able to create this game as I improved my own knowledge of computer programming. So here we have is the title screen with the name Fairy Hunter and the play button. Once you click play, you are transitioned to the mission screen where you are greeted by the Fairy Queen and she will present you the mission that you need to accomplish. The Fairy Queen is saying, "Lone traveler, I am in need of your assistance. Many of my fairies have escaped into the human world and they are playing pranks and jokes on normal humans that can't see them. They are using fairy pollen in order to cast illusions on humans. So in this game, you are a lone traveler and the Fairy Queen has a mission for you to capture her fairies that have escaped into the human world that are playing pranks on humans using the special forbidden fairy pollen that casts illusions on anyone that inhales it into their body or anyone that comes into contact with it." The Fairy Queen continues by saying, "If you could, please help me capture these fairies and bring them back here to me." And she asks, "Can you please help me?" You are presented with two options of yes or no. If you click no, you will be transitioned into the ending screen where it shows you how many fairies that you have captured and what your score is. If you click yes, it will guide you to your characters where you would choose one out of three characters and they will be the character that you'll be playing with throughout this game. So here I will choose the one on the left, and I click next, and it will show you the controls, where in this game you will require your mouse to drag your character around, and D is to rotate clockwise, and A is to rotate counterclockwise. S is to stop whenever your fairy's controls becomes too hard for you to control. Since we are dealing with fairies, fairies are known to have rapid movement and quick pace, so the S is there to stop your fairy from moving too quick. And the goal is to destroy pollen in order to lure out the fairies and then capture as many fairies as possible. And then you click play to continue, and on the game screen, press enter or return to start playing. As you see here, whenever I click my mouse in certain locations, it drags my characters to that place. S is to stop, D rotate counterclockwise. Here comes the first pollen, so I will start shooting. And then as you can see, fairies start appearing. And then there are three different types of fairies. One is the one where you see shooting out rainbow knives at you. These are the fairies that are trying to prevent you from capturing them. The one with the deadly stars are also there to damage you as much as possible. The one shooting out red bullets is the one that's trying to distract you. As you can see that there are so many red bullets that you might not keep track of your own character as you get distracted by the red bullets themselves. And then, whenever you die, you are transitioned to the ending screen where you have the number of fairies captured, wave number, and how many points that you scored as you play the game. If you want to play again, click play again and you'll be moved back to the title screen.